Have you ever noticed electricity just goes out and then it comes back instantly? Again, if it goes out, then it comes back after 10 to 15 seconds. And if electricity goes out again, then it takes several hours to come back. If your answer is yes, then basically what you have experienced is a reclosing duty or operating cycle of a circuit breaker. In this video, we will be talking about what is auto reclosing and what is a duty or operating cycle of a circuit breaker. We will also talk about what is single phase and three phase duty cycle, and for that you need to watch the video. Hello and welcome. If you are new here, my name is Gaurav J and I post videos related to different topics of electrical engineering in easiest way. And if that is the area of your interest, then consider subscribing to the channel. Now, let's talk about the reclosing. This video was actually requested by one of our subscribers. Now, consider this is a transmission line and this is one circuit breaker which is switching on and switching off this line. Right now, the breaker is in closed position and the transmission line is delivering power. Let's say there is a lightning stroke, or maybe a bird crashed on the line and one of the phases touched the ground. So there will be a fault and the relay will give command to circuit breaker and the breaker will open. Now the supply has been interrupted. Once the bird took off, the fault will clear quickly, but unless the operator operates the breaker, the supply will not be restored. Now, I gave you example of bird crashing, but there can be other causes of fault like lightning strike or some objects coming in contact with the line, wind causing jumper loops to flash over to the tower legs, or maybe farmers burning stubble in their field. All of these scenarios are the most common scenarios which causes fault. And there is one common thing in all these scenarios, and that common thing is fault created by these scenarios are transient in nature. Now, what do we mean by transient? It means that a fault that remains in the system for a very short time and then it goes off automatically. So I notice that majority of the fault occurring on my line are transient in nature, which is caused by all these reasons. The fault will remain for a very short time and then it will go away automatically. But every time the circuit breaker opens after a fault, I need to operate that breaker manually to bring back the supply and system stability. Now, when I know that the fault will go away automatically majority of the time, instead of operating breaker manually, can I operate breaker automatically? Well, the answer is yes. And that's where auto reclosing comes into picture. Auto reclosing is basically an automatic reclosing. In the early days, line operators soon realized that when an overhead line tripped out of service, in the majority of the cases, the fault was transient in nature. And this scenario is true for 90 to 95% cases. This is based on the data collected and studies made. If the circuit was reclosed, then the circuit would return to its service without any need of human intervention. In the early days, this reclosing of circuit breaker was carried out manually by the operator. It soon became apparent that it would be beneficial if the reclosing action was carried out automatically, which enabled it to be much faster and so possible to assist in maintaining system stability under some fault conditions. So that is nothing but the auto reclosing. Now, let us talk about duty cycle of a circuit breaker. If you would have seen a nameplate of a medium or high and extra high voltage circuit breaker, you would have seen something called as duty cycle or rated operating duty cycle, or few people also call it as auto reclosing cycle. By the way, if you are interested in knowing the nameplate details of different substation equipment, then I have a dedicated playlist on that, link for which I'll provide down in the description. So, this duty cycle is basically an operating sequence which circuit breaker should be able to perform during an auto reclosing. So let us break down this cycle to understand. Please note, O represents an opening operation and C represents closing operation of a circuit breaker. Let's say there is a transient fault. Protective relay gives command to circuit breaker and it opens. And that's the first O. And after a delay of 0.3 second, the circuit breaker will receive a command to close. Now 0.3 second delay is given so that the arc caused by the transient fault would go away and air will have its dielectric strength back. So if the fault is clear, the breaker will remain in the closed condition and the system is back in normal operation without any human intervention. But if the fault is still not clear, then breaker will immediately receive an open command. After that, the breaker will wait again for 3 minutes. After that, one more close command will be given to the breaker. Again, if the fault is cleared, then the breaker will remain closed. If the fault is still not clear, then again breaker will get an opening command and now it will remain open unless closed manually. Now, the duty cycle that we saw was meant for rapid auto reclosing. There is another variant in this, which you can see on your screen. The only change is that instead of 0.3 seconds, it is now 3 minutes. And this duty cycle is not meant for a rapid auto reclosing. If the first timing is 0.3 seconds, then it means it is for rapid auto reclosing. And if it is 3 minutes, then it is not meant for rapid auto reclosing. Just take a note of that. These auto reclosing cycles are defined by the different standards, like this one is defined by the IEC standards. IEC also defines one more duty cycle, which you can see on your screen. Now, what is single phase and three phase auto reclosing? Let's talk about that. Let's say there is a fault only on one phase. Now, in such case, only a single phase is tripped and the balance two phases are still in operation. And circuit breaker will try to reclose that one faulty phase only. And this type of reclosing is called as single phase auto reclosing because we are only trying to reclose one phase. But it is important to note that single phase auto reclosing can only be performed by an electrically gang operated circuit breaker. That means every phase of circuit breaker will have its own dedicated mechanism. In that case only, a circuit breaker will be able to trip or close one phase out of three. If the breaker is mechanically gang operated type, then it cannot perform single phase auto reclosing duty. It can only perform three phase auto reclosing duty, wherein all the three phases are reclosed. Let me know in the comment section for which ratings generally MGO type breaker and EGO type breaker are used. I hope this was useful and you learned something from this video. If the video was helpful, then do like the video and comment yes in the comment section to let me know. If you are interested in understanding the concepts in such an easy to understanding way, then make sure you subscribe to the channel with the bell notification turned on so that you won't miss any of the future updates. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll see you in my next one. But till then, keep watching, keep learning.